YouTube, what's up my people? I'm back again with another reaction. My name is Polisa, and today we are reacting to a request that was made by one of the subscribers who was basically telling me about that I should look up. So that's what I'm gonna be doing today. And yeah, I hope you guys are gonna enjoy the reaction. I had a lot of people, they trashed it a lot, and they said that this was the worst album that Eminem has ever released. So for me, they were shocking, first of all, because I don't think Eminem is capable of making bad music, never mind bad album. So that got me to be curious, like, was the album that bad? You know, like, I understand a song, but an album, and it doesn't sound like Eminem at all. So I'm gonna give this album a chance. I'm gonna react to it, and just to check if, I mean, I'm gonna share the same sentiments with everyone. Yeah, the first track that the subscriber suggested was Walk on Water. Eminem is featuring Beyonce on this track, and yeah, cool. Yeah, I haven't heard Beyonce, like, it's been a while since I've heard any released from Beyonce, and she has a very beautiful voice. She has a very beautiful voice. So growing up, I enjoyed listening to Beyonce. So I think that I should enjoy listening to her now, you know, with that voice of hers. So yeah, you know, if you like the reaction, please leave a like. Also subscribe to the channel, and yeah, make some suggestions if you have any songs from the album or any other album that Eminem released in the past. Yeah, this is me basically catching up with what Eminem has been up to from, I'll say, 2010. Like I said, I've been, yeah, basically deaf to the American hip-hop industry for 10 years now. So this is me, you know, being reintroduced to the hip-hop game back in America, and I'm doing it through Eminem. So let's do this. You know, there's a video for this song, so I hope you guys are gonna enjoy it.
This video is very cinematic already. I'm loving it.
Why are expectations so high? Is it the bar I set, my arms I stretch, but I can't reach a far cry from it, or it's in my grasp, but as soon as I grab squeeze, I lose my grip like the flying trapeze. Into the dark I plummet. Now the sky's blackening. I know the mark's high, but flies rip apart my stomach. Knowing that no matter what bars I come with, you're gonna heart gripe, and that's a hard fight getting to swallow. So I scrap these as pressure increases like khakis. I feel the ice cracking because.
Whoa. Okay. First of all, so basically. I love the piano. I was expecting a beat. I won't lie. I was expecting the beat to drop, you know. I thought maybe the piano is just an introduction to the song, but I was just waiting there expecting a beat. But I love it. I love it. And Eminem flow is very poetic, you know. I guess the reason, the intention behind this track was really to focus on what he had to say more than the beat and hyping up to the music. So, yeah, this is cool. And, so far, it feels like he's basically talking about how people hold him at a very high standard, and so every time he has to be creative, he needs to make sure that he meet those expectations. And I'm guessing those are the fans, of course, of his. And because he has set the bar too high for him, so he basically every time they write something, he throw it away because he doesn't think that it's of the same caliber of the previous recordings that he has made in the past. And I can understand that, you know, for someone who's very creative and talented and who has made great music like Eminem, it must be really difficult to come up with something new and refresh and that will entice, you know, the hip-hop community, especially the fans, you know, that are really core Eminem supporters. So, and they have sort of like expectation and an idea of what he must do and how he should, yeah, like they have the expectation. We're just gonna say that. But yeah, let's continue. So far the track is nice, you know, it's very mellow, but I like it. And this is the scenery here. It reminds me of the track Darkness from his recent album. This scene right here, it reminds me of that. And to think about it, that track also didn't, was also a metal track, you know, which was basically not a very hype track. It was very conscious, and he was drawing you to himself and what he was saying. So he's basically taking the same, I mean, this was before the recent album, so he basically used the same method, you know, to try and make sure that people really listen to what he has to say, because he has a message, you know, because there's no beat, there's no bouncing, it's just him spitting. Let's continue. Whew, okay, this video is gonna be long.
It's the curse of the standard, the curse of the...
I walk on water only when it freezes. Wow. That's a nice way of looking at it, you know? Because at the end of the day, even though the water is solid, it's still water, you know? And you can walk on water when it's frozen. So, yeah. So, I mean, he's no Jesus, which is a nice parable.
It's the curse of the standard, the first of the Mathers disc set. Always in search of the verse that I haven't spit yet. Will this step just be another misstep to tarnish whatever the legacy, love, or respect I've garnered? The rhyme has to be perfect, the delivery flawless. And it always feels like I'm hitting the mark till I go sit in the car, listen, and pick it apart. Like this shit is garbage.
That must be tough, man. Imagine someone as creative as Eminem. Because I think that even the wackest thing that Eminem can write on a paper will be still be better than most of the music that's out there. I appreciate, as a fan, I appreciate the fact that Eminem takes time to write his music, because no wonder the quality is so high up there, you know. And it doesn't that anyone can match it by him but himself, because he puts so much work in it, and I respect it. I respect it. I think that if you're really passionate about something, and I believe Eminem is really passionate about hip-hop and rap, the art of it, because I've said this in my previous video, he's basically pointing that out. What up to Eminem?
God's given me all this, still I feel no different regardless. Kids look to me as a god, this is retarded. If only they knew, it's a facade and it's exhaustive. I try not to listen to nonsense, but if you bitches are trying to strip me of my confidence, mission accomplished. I'm not Godson, Nas, Rock, Kim, Pop, Big, James, Todd, Smith, and I'm not Prince.
Damn, and he just mentioned the legends right there. He just mentioned the legends. Yeah, ne? I love that about Eminem. He's not scared of mentioning, like, the people who are before him and the people that inspired him to become who he is, you know, that he looked up to. So I respect that, you know, because normally artists, when they get big or when they blow up, they get cocky, all of a sudden it's all about them and no one else exists but them. So that's for me, that's what up, you know. Those Prince, Pop, all of those people that he mentioned, Rakim, those are legends, you know. So those are pioneers of this music industry. So what up, man, what up. I love that. And Beyonce's voice is so beautiful, guys. Like, it's so beautiful. She's hitting those notes. Two great creatives coming together and making a beautiful song like this is great. I'm sure most artists go through that, the anxiety of letting the fans down, you know, the people who see them as these great artists, it might be really something depressing. And look, you can't justify someone using drugs, you know, but if you think about some of the things that, of the emotions that we as normal people go through compared to what artists, because even though they are normal, they are still artists. Like they live a very extravagant life. Like everything is big, you know. If it's good, it's totally super good. If it's bad, it's super bad. So to them, there's no in between most of the time. Talk about mega artists now. I'm sure they don't experience in between, you know, like we do as normal people, if you know what I'm saying. So yeah, that must be terrifying.
It's true, I'm a Rubik's, a beautiful mess, at times juvenile, yes, I goof and I jest, a flawed human, I guess, but I'm doing my best to not ruin your expectations and meet them, but first, the speed them verse. Now Big Sean, he's going too fast, is he gonna shout or curse out his mom? There was a time I had the world by the balls eating out my palm. Every album song I was spazzing the fuck out on, and now I'm getting clowned and frowned on. But the only one who's looking down on me that matters now is Deshaun. Am I lucky to be around this long? Begs the question though, especially after...
No, Eminem, you're not lucky, you're talented, bro. Like, you're talented. It's not by luck, you're talented. And you should do you.
The dome is yesterday fades, and the Dresden home is burnt to the ground, and all that's left of my house is lawn. The crowds are gone, and it's time to wash out the blonde. Sales decline, the curtains drawn, they're closing the set. I'm still poking my head from out behind, and everyone who has doubt remind. Now take your best rhyme, outdo it, now do it 1,000 times. Now let them tell you the world no longer cares or gives a fuck about your rhymes.
I care about your rhymes, Eminem. I truly care, man. I truly care. Because you speak sense. You know, you speak sense. I understand you. I understand what you're saying. Dang. And yeah, keep on writing, man.
As I grow out of sight, out of mind, I might go out of mind. Because how do I ever let this mic go without a fight? When I made a fucking tightrope out of twine. But when I do fall from these heights, though I'll be fine. I won't powder cry or spiral down a wine. But I've decided this my final bout this time around. Cause
I'm on water. But I ain't no Jesus.
That was creepy as F.
Music suggested by you guys, because so far I've been listening to some good tracks. All right, see you later.